Hello, YouTube, and my future creepy self. Yep, you right there. You are creepy. Anyway, so it's been quite a while since I last made a YouTube video. About 5 months, actually. It feels ages ago, because for me personally, at least, a lot has happened. Maybe it wouldn't be considered a lot, but it's quite a lot. So 5 months since I last actually sat behind a camera like this and just talked. So since it's been that long, I'm not really sure if I'm still capable of blabbering on in front of a camera. Actually, I'm not really sure if I was really good at that any time before anyway. Anyway, enough downing myself. Let's go get into the nitty-gritty of the purpose of this video, which is just a simple update of my life, really. Haven't done that in a long while, so the last time I made a video, let's see, what was happening was, I guess I made that video about walking around from Brooklyn to Bronx as a test to see how well I would be as a dog walker, because I was applying to be a dog walker. I was applying to be really anything that would help me pay rent to stay in New York City. That's what it's all about. I was in a precarious situation back then. Man, it still feels like ages ago because my situation has drastically changed for the better. That's the spoiler right there of my life. But yeah, it was a precarious situation. It's a situation where, okay, so I have to move out. I have to find a new apartment because my lease is about to be up and my two roommates, they're going their separate ways. So somehow I have to find a new apartment which has cheap rent and whatnot. So that's another thing. The other thing is I'm practically unemployed. I mean, at the time I was employed as a tutor for Champion Learning Center. But in Champion Learning Center, you're considered as an independent contractor. So they just assign the students and you really have to do everything else afterwards. You have to do the scheduling, the paperwork, and the tutoring. And I'm only paid $15 per hour of tutoring. Everything else, like the paperwork, the scheduling, the emailing and all that, that's just part of the job. I don't get paid for that. So $15 an hour, that's all I'm getting. The problem is that the company doesn't stay in operation during the summer. So from June to November, the company is just not providing tutoring services at all. It's like April then. I was having a problem like around April, around May or something like that. I think around May was when I was like really, really struggling. So I'm practically unemployed because there are no students to tutor. I have two students that I'm assigned to, both of whom are very hard to schedule sessions with. Like this one student, I would have to go to the library to meet with him and to tutor, but he wouldn't be there or he wouldn't be at his school. So I only get paid if I tutor. So I would go there, student wouldn't be there. I'd come back home and be like, just wasted, you know, commute time there. So both my students were like that. Very challenging students, very hard to get actual hours out of. So practically unemployed, I'm working like barely like, I'm supposed to, each student is about 4 hours a week, but with me not meeting them, I'm barely getting like 6 hours a week. So 6 times 15 is what, like $90? $90 per week. That's my income at that time, which is like pretty horrible with my rent at like $580. My student loan payment, which at that time I was so behind on. I was 110 days behind. And at my peak, that's what it got to. And at that peak, I was $4,000 in back payment. So I owed Citibank like $4,000. And they have a policy with their private loans of if you are behind 120 days, then you just are automatically default. In that case, you weren't able to pay your student loans and your credit score is done. Just completely demolished for like 7 years or so. So I'm 10 days away from default. I'm practically unemployed. I've applied to pretty much like 70 different positions. All hope is lost. So that one Saturday at like 11 p.m., I call my mom and I tell her, you know, it's like, Mom, I think I'm done here. I think I'm done in New York City. this is where I want to be because it has a lot of opportunities as a social work major. But I think I'm done. I don't think there's anything for me here. I tried calling the pastor, your son, you wanted me to call to see if I could get that, whatever, like a summer Bible school teacher's assistant kind of position in Queens, New York. They didn't get back to me. No one's getting back to me. I have no experience other than as an intern. I'm just underqualified for all these jobs. And even if I am qualified, the job market is so tight that I kind of have to be a little bit overqualified. I need to have some kind of experience, like a year or two, which I don't. I only have it as an intern. So I'm done. Mom, I'm coming back to Tennessee where you are and maybe live under your roof, try to find something in Tennessee. But I know, like, at least for my field, there's hardly anything in Tennessee, like, with the bachelor's. If I had a master's, maybe I have a better chance, but I have a bachelor's in social work. So, very precarious situation, and I just given up. It's not that, what really hit me was when I watched the movie Toy Story 3. In Toy Story 3, there's that one moment where all the Woody and the rest and Buzz and the rest of the gang are in this incinerator, and they're about to die. Incinerator is going to this like fire of doom, whatever. They're about to die. They know they're about to die, so they don't fight it. They just give up. And there's this moment where the camera kind of zooms in, and everyone it shows people like trying to hold on to each other, holding their hands, and just it's like this is their moment of like death, and they just accept it, and they're ready to die together. That moment really struck me, because I was like, I mean, it's not as drastic as that, but it was just like, that's how I was right now. I was like, fine, I'll go home. And I accepted it. The day after that call, this company, BRC, Bahri Residence Committee, it's a private nonprofit company that runs about 20 different homeless shelters around New York City. They called me. The lady on the phone was a HR representative, and she was like, oh, are you still interested in the position that you interviewed for? And I had actually gone through two interviews with BRC. I thought there was a good chance, but they hadn't gotten back to me like in 3 weeks. It's like been about 3.5 weeks since I did the second interview with them. So I didn't know. But so this phone call is 3.5 weeks later. Are you still interested in the position? I'm like, yes, definitely. And that's when she told me, like, oh, okay. And so congratulations, you're hired. like that last moment, the day after I'd given up. It's like that Toy Story moment too. They all given up, and then those little three aliens come with the crane and rescue them. It's like the moment you give up is the moment you get rescued. It was kind of like that for me. So she told me my schedule, which is the overnight shift from midnight to 8:30, from Wednesdays to Sundays. So which actually works out for me because I'm pretty nocturnal. But now I love to sleep during the day. I hate waking up early in the morning. I've never been like an early bird. So one of the things that concerned me about getting a job was, oh man, the dog walking position that I applied for, that job starts 6 in the morning. So, I'd have to wake up 5 in the morning for that job. But this job, it starts midnight. So, not a problem. Graveyard shifts I've done before as a security guard. So, great. Got that. There's still that $4,000 student loan that I'm behind on that I have to worry about. But that's where my parents, that's where my mom really saved me. Because she realized that her 401k that she took out a year before, well, she actually didn't take out all of it. She still had about $10,000 left. So what she had, like half of it, she actually gave to me, with which I paid back that loan payment I was behind on, and also used that to find an apartment. And this is my apartment right now. This is my room. So what I'm paying for is the room. And I share the bathroom and the kitchen with the other residents in the building. Not a big problem though, because not many of the residents actually fully use the kitchen. And there's one bathroom and then there's a half bathroom, which I guess I'm like the only person using. So not a bad setup. Utilities are included with the rent payment. Not a bad setup other than the fact that I have to use this for internet. this is a wireless router. It's internet anywhere and everywhere pretty much, as long as this thing is charged with battery. The only catch is that it has a 5 GB data limit, so I can't use more than 5 GB of data on it online. Otherwise, I'd pay an extra fee. And I have to have this because this building, there's an issue where the cable, if I have cable, the wires are going to run out of the building because the cable box isn't grounded. So it's a grounding issue, and the cable company wasn't willing to, like, work around that, like, work with that, you know, because they have to kind of restructure the cable system in order to install it. The cable representative was like, okay, a supervisor will come see you tomorrow. The supervisor never came. That statement was just kind of appeased me, I guess. So, not able to have actual cable, just have to stick with this for internet. That's the bad thing, I guess. The bad thing is I can't really watch Netflix all that much online streaming, and I can't really do online gaming all that much. But the good thing is, from that precarious, like, I'm doomed situation to now, where I'm a full-time worker in a field that I've trained for. You know, I've gone to college for social work, and this is a non-profit field. You know, I work in a homeless shelter, which is great. It's stressful and frustrating a lot of times because it's a startup operation. You know, they just made this brand new building, so there's just still a lot of things that are just like out of whack. But it's a great job. It's a great gig. I think I could stick to, like, you know, 2 or 3 years kind of thing. So got that. Got a new apartment. I'm able to afford it. I'm able to actually pay my student loan payments, which is $200 more than my rent. It was ridiculously high, but able to do it. And I have a girlfriend. That happened too. So quite, to me personally, like, quite a lot of happenings, you know. Life is good. So that's just the update. I probably would have a lot more details to talk about later. But, you know, I could always make more videos for that. Hopefully you don't have to wait 5 more months for that video. So hopefully I'm more frequent with the video. And, you know, I'll keep you in the loop. Alright, take care, guys.